Hey guys, Jobby Zomba here, and welcome back to another video. Now, this is a very random video. I just had a very random thought. I thought I would rank the Hammer Christopher Lee Dracula deaths. I've got 7 to go through, and we're going to be going from worst to best. So let's start the countdown. Taste the blood of Dracula. I have to be honest, in my opinion, I think this death is very lazy, and it's definitely the weakest death in the Christopher Lee Hammer Dracula franchise. Not the weakest film, however. I believe that the weakest film, in my opinion, is The Satanic Rites of Dracula. But I find this movie to be somewhat repetitive. I mean, Christopher Lee's hardly in the movie, and his dialogue is practically the same. The first, the second, the third. And my favourite line that he actually delivers in this movie is,
"They have destroyed my servant. They will be destroyed."
But as for his death...
So basically, Paul goes to an abandoned church, which was the same church that Dracula in this movie was resurrected in. And in the movie, there was a character named Lord Courtney, who's played by the always amazing Ralph Bates. And basically what Paul does is that he swaps Lord Courtney's cloak for a white one, he swaps the black candles for white ones, and he just revamps the church, and it literally kills Dracula. After a short confrontation, Dracula climbs onto a balcony and throws objects at Paul and another character, Alice, who's one of the main female characters in the movie. And before backing into a glass window depicting a cross, he breaks the glass but suddenly sees the changed surroundings. And here's the Lord's Prayer recited in Latin. And I kid you not, he literally falls off the balcony onto the altar and just disintegrates into dust. I think this film could have been so much better if Christopher Lee was in the film a lot more and had a lot more dialogue. But it's just, yeah, I just find this film really repetitive. So that's my number 7 spot. Coming in at number 6 is Dracula AD 1972. Without a doubt, this is the cheesiest film in the Dracula franchise, and possibly the most fun, and the soundtrack is just laughable. After finding out that his granddaughter is under Dracula's command, Professor Van Helsing goes to a graveyard and begins to set up a pit trap for Dracula. The final confrontation is pretty much like a cat and mouse game. Dracula and Van Helsing run around and chase each other in a church. But then Van Helsing has the upper hand, or so he thinks, and stabs the Count with a silver knife. But because his granddaughter is under Dracula's command, she ends up removing the knife from Dracula's chest. Van Helsing then goes outside and trips. It is then that Dracula notices the trap that Van Helsing set for him. But he strikes again and throws the holy water at the Count. He falls on a rock and into the pit onto the stakes. Van Helsing then grabs a shovel and pushes it into Dracula's back, impaling him even further onto the stakes. Then, in classic fashion, he crumbles into dust, leaving only his ring behind, just like at the start of the film. The number 5 spot goes to The Scars of Dracula, and in my opinion, this is Christopher Lee's most evil portrayal as Dracula, next to his portrayal in The Satanic Rites of Dracula. In this movie, he continuously stabs one of his female brides, Tanya, with a dagger for betraying him. He also punishes his servant Clove, and by doing this, he grabs a sword, heats it up by the fire, and viciously places it on Clove's back. Not to mention, when Clove admits to his sin, you can see previous scars which have been caused by the Count torturing him over the years. In the finale, Clove confronts the Count but does not have the upper hand. After a short scuffle, Dracula throws Clove off of the castle. And then we come to Dracula's death. The main hero, Simon, removes an iron rod near a wall and throws it at Dracula. It manages to impale him, but as always, this does not stop the Count. He removes it from his chest, raises it, and in mind, attempts to do the same at Simon. But out of nowhere, a bolt of lightning appears, strikes the iron rod, and Dracula is immediately engulfed in flames, throwing himself about on top of the castle, wailing in agony. And at one point, you can clearly see it's a stunt performer in a really bad Christopher Lee mask. Eventually, Dracula falls off of the top of the castle, and a very good shot shows Dracula, from afar, still alight, falling to his death screaming. It's fantastic. The death that I chose for number four is the Count's death in The Satanic Rites of Dracula. In my mind, this is the worst film in the Christopher Lee Dracula series. I remember watching it on a really bad, low-quality recording on VHS. But yet again, much like Dracula AD 1972, it makes up with Christopher Lee and Peter Cushing in the same movie. And unfortunately, this would be their last movie as Dracula and Van Helsing. Yet again, Dracula is so evil in this film. He wants to create something similar to the plague and wipe out the human race. But Christopher Lee has some amazing lines of dialogue in this film.
Four horsemen of my created apocalypse. Four carriers of the plague who will infect their miserable brethren. You, Van Helsing, are now one of the four.
As for his death, Van Helsing lures Dracula into a hawthorn bush where he's entangled. Dracula eventually manages to free himself, but falls over and his foot is caught. Van Helsing then grabs a stake from a nearby fence and rams it into Dracula's heart, and as per usual, he disintegrates into dust. Now, what I love about this death is the symbolism of Christ, where Christ would wear the crown of thorns. For the worst Christopher Lee Dracula movie, in my opinion, it makes up for having a good death scene, and this would be the last time that Peter Cushing as Van Helsing kills Christopher Lee as Count Dracula. My memory is correct. Dracula, Prince of Darkness was the film that got me into Hammer horror. I absolutely love this movie and I hold it close to my heart. I love the opening with the recap of the first film, and it was Hammer's first Dracula movie to introduce the Count's iconic red and black cloak. Christopher Lee is amazing in this film and he does it without any dialogue. The reason for this is because Lee read the script and refused to say any of the lines because he hated the dialogue. It wasn't Stoker's Dracula. So, after Prince of Darkness was released, Hammer banged out another Dracula movie. But Christopher didn't want anything to do with it. Hammer begged for Christopher Lee to return to the role, but he still wasn't going to.
I have no further use for you.
Then they openly admitted that they already sold the film to the American audience with Christopher Lee in the role.
You!
And the sole reason why he continued to play the character was because Hammer said to him, think of the people you'll put out of work if you don't do the film. So that's the reason why he continued to play Dracula. He considered everyone as friends. But I digress. A new way to kill a vampire in this movie is running water. Sure enough, that's how Dracula dies. Dracula's coffin is thrown onto ice and one of the film's main heroes, Charles Kent, attempts to stake Dracula. But nightfall has fallen and the Count rises from his coffin. The two characters get into a scuffle and then one of the film's main female characters, Diana, suggests to Father Sandor, who's another leading character, that he shoots Dracula. But he knows it will do no good. So, Diana shoots the ice and sure enough, there's our new way to kill Dracula. Sandor then takes over and begins to shoot the ice. Dracula is cornered as Kent flees. The ice then breaks and Dracula is taken underwater to freeze. That is until the next movie, which is... Dracula has risen from the grave. My favourite title in the Dracula series, and Hammer's fourth Dracula movie, and it's one of the best. Dracula is resurrected when a priest, who in the film is left unnamed, trips and bangs his head. The blood from the head wound trickles into a frozen stream through a crack in the ice and onto the lips of Count Dracula. What I love about this movie is that there is a character named Paul, which I think was Hammer's favourite name because they use that name for their male leads in the majority of their Dracula movies. But in this movie, the character of Paul has lost faith and is an atheist. So there's a scene where the priest and Paul join to kill Count in his coffin. Paul stakes Dracula in the chest, and we get some good shots of blood coming from Dracula's chest. But in order for the Count to die, Paul has to pray.
Pray. You must pray.
I can't.
You must, or he won't die.
You pray, you're a priest. You pray.
This is the first time that this has ever been used in one of the Dracula series. However, he can't because he doesn't believe. Dracula then removes the stake and in a fit of rage throws it back at Paul. But in the final confrontation, Dracula kidnaps Maria and flees to Castle Dracula. However, he's unable to enter because a golden cross is guarding the church doors. The Count instructs Maria to remove the cross and throw it away. Paul then comes to the rescue and, as usual, Dracula and our hero get into a scuffle. But somehow, Paul manages to throw Dracula off of the castle parapet. Paul survives the fall by catching a nearby tree branch, but it doesn't end so well for the Count. Dracula falls to his death and is impaled on the golden cross which was thrown below by Maria. Whilst wailing in agony, reaching out, attempting to free himself, the priest recites the Lord's Prayer in Latin, and Count Dracula is then seen with tears of blood running down his face. It's absolutely fantastic. He finally dissolves, making this my second favourite Dracula death. And of course, the number one spot goes to the film that kicked off Christopher Lee as Count Dracula, and that's Dracula, or known in the US as Horror of Dracula. Out of all the films in the franchise, I would say that this is the closest to Bram Stoker's novel, and it certainly has the best cast. Christopher Lee, Peter Cushing, and Michael Goff. And the score by James Bernard is just amazing. But the Count's death in this film, in my opinion, is the most amazing and classic of them all. Dracula attempts to bury Mina outside, but stops as he sees Van Helsing approaching. A chase then emerges between the Count and Van Helsing inside of Castle Dracula. Dracula attempts to get into his coffin, but Van Helsing beats him to it. Dracula then has the upper hand by strangling Van Helsing, but I guess you could say that Van Helsing does a fake out, so Dracula goes in for the kill. Van Helsing manages to release himself from Dracula's grip. Then he suddenly jumps onto a nearby table, runs toward the library windows, and manages to pull down the curtain. Dracula is now left screaming in pain as sunlight has approached and his body is disintegrating. But Van Helsing isn't finished. He grabs two candlesticks and holds them into the form of a cross, pushing Dracula further into the sunlight. This death at the time was heavily cut. The uncut footage was discovered in a vault in Japan. It showed just a few more scenes of disintegration, as well as Dracula clawing the flesh off his face. It's brilliant. So guys, that has been my ranking of the Christopher Lee Hammer Dracula deaths. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, leave a like. It lets me know if you enjoyed the video, and as always, take care.
Now my revenge is complete.